Make me whole. Please restore my soul and make me whole. Here's my heart. Here's my soul.
Praise the Lord. Also, we'd like to welcome all visitors. You know what? When you see my eyebrows all furrowed, I'm not upset at you, okay? I just hate false doctrine. I do, and I believe God is going to give me, I'm thinking about it this morning, I'm going to preach on a sermon what they call legalism or liberty. Legalism and liberty. How many know there's a difference between them? And so many people are bound by legalism. You understand? By legalism, by church rules. It has nothing to do with the Word of God.
Amen.
Nothing to do with the Word of God. But we serve a God that came and died on Calvary's cross and gave us liberty.
Amen. Thank you.
Not license to sin, but liberty. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. I hate false doctrine. Not the people, but false doctrine, I hate it. I was under legalism at one time. Years ago, 1975. Legalism.
Amen.
But I knew in my heart that I knew I was trying to measure up. Measure up, just trying to live as close to God as I could, but it was failing God. But I knew that God would give me a chance, that God would open it up to me one day, and He did. Praise the Lord. And now I can live for God.
Amen.
Sin doesn't have to dominate me. I can have power. I do have power over sin. Amen.
Amen.
You can as well. Sin doesn't have to dominate you.
Amen.
I'm so sick of people. Just like a 12 step. I'm an alcoholic. And I'm not going to walk around the rest of my life saying I'm an alcoholic. No, I've been born again. I'm redeemed. I'm a brother of the Lamb.
Hallelujah.
If I have a problem with alcohol or whatever, God can set me free.
That's right.
Not just on the cross for our salvation, He died that we might be free.
Yeah. Amen.
And have the victory. Amen. Glory to God. He can take that taste away.
Yes,
amen. You just keep trusting God. You just keep coming. You just keep giving God all the praise.
Amen.
One day you'll wake up and I'm going to be gone. Glory to God.
Amen.
Yes, amen. Your violation won't get any credit for it. Your pastor won't get any credit for it. You say, look and see what the Lord has done.
Glory to God.
If you have your Bibles, turn to the book of Matthew, please. And thank you guys for coming to church. I'm glad you guys are not rain Christians.
Amen.
When it rains, you don't come. Come on, somebody.
Yes,
Matthew chapter 5, please. I know we have to push past those things, the elements or whatever. We come to the house of God.
Amen.
You push through the rain to go to work.
Come on.
Amen.
You push through the rain to go to SISBA. Glory to God. You can push through the rain to come to church.
Amen.
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 Oh, praise the Lord. Chapter 5. We'll try to hold you too long today. But like I got some. Got something on my mind. Beans and rice. Glory to God. Hey, I've been on the Bible saying He gives us good things to eat. I'm telling you right now, there's a place in Portside called Heaven's Barbecue. Am I right? Come on, sister, say amen. Woo! She said, yes, yes. Woo! The tri-tip and the ribs are off the chain. She bit into her, she went like, ooh, this is good. Amen. Praise the Lord. So they'll be there until the last of this month.
Amen.
So I think we need to get together and go over there, huh?
Amen.
They're Christian.
Amen.
They're Christian. Heavenly Father, please. What road is that on? It's
you turn left at the 76.
What's the name?
Highway 95.
Yeah. On the left hand side, Heaven's Barbecue.
They're closed on Sunday.
Huh? They're closed on Sunday. Yes, but they went out. That's where we're going. Amen. But have your Bibles turn to Matthew 5:13, please. It says, "You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt has lost its savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is thenceforth good for nothing, but to be cast out and to be trodden underfoot of men. He said, you are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick. And it gives light unto all who are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they might see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. I'd like to use for study this morning, salt and light. Can we pray? Dear Heavenly Father, we give you praise and glory this morning, God. I just ask, oh God, that you would help us to get through this sermon, Lord. I ask you, God, that you would touch my body, Lord, that I might be able to preach what I believe that you laid upon my heart. Let me not be annoying to those who are listening, God. But Lord, I ask that you would dry up everything that has to do with my respiratory system, God.
Yes.
That I might be able to preach, to teach the word. And we ask you in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
There are two responsibilities that believers have. One is being the salt of the earth and the light of the world. I'll say it again. There's two responsibilities that we have as Christians. To be the salt of the earth and the light of the world. A commentator says salt is a type of the word of God. The professing believer who no longer holds to the word of God is of no use to God or man. End quote. Light is not to be hid, but how many know it is to be seen?
Yes.
I was thinking about a lighthouse. What good is a lighthouse if it's enclosed inside a cement silo? Yes, inside the silo there's light, but outside there's no light protruding. And I thought about that. I got this message from going down Broadway one night. I guess they're doing some work there, and they had some signs around a manhole, but there were no flashing lights. So if you didn't really know Broadway, you might have ran into those lights. There was no lights to warn the people. And I thought about Christians, how we are sometimes. No one knows that we're Christians. And how do you know the world's supposed to know that we're Christians?
Yes.
Or, well, Pastor, you know, I could just come to church and just, you know, and do what I have to do. And no, that's not, it's more than that. Amen. The people outside those doors are supposed to know that you are the light of the world. Amen. That you are a Christian. That's not, you're not supposed to hide the fact that you are a child of Almighty God.
Amen.
There's light within, but having no light protruding out. We haven't been called to think about are we the light or to question it or to research it. God says that you are the salt and you are the light, period. And you can't do anything about it. So what I'm saying is God expects for you to be light. He expects you to be salt wherever you at. I don't care whether it's on your job. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
I don't care if it's at a football game. Amen. I don't care if it's at a family barbecue. You're supposed to be the salt of the earth and the light of the world. That's not the time that you're supposed to put down being a Christian for an hour. Oh, so amen.
Amen.
How do some of us can shed Christianity for about 1 or 2 hours on New Year's Eve? Or at a barbecue.
Amen.
Everybody else might be drinking alcohol, but how do you know you're not supposed to touch it?
Amen.
Amen.
Everybody else might be saying, talking with profanity in their mouth, but how do you know you're not supposed to be profane?
Amen.
At all.
Right.
And some of you around me have let things slip out of your mouth before. You need a heart change. You need to clean that language up. Amen.
Amen.
Because the Bible says, from the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks.
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
We must take what the word of God says. We must believe what the word of God says. We must obey what the God what the word of God says, and we must be what the word of God says.
Yes.
Wow.
Amen.
Amen.
Now the devil in your flesh might tell you you're not worthy in the world, and guess what? They're right. None of us are worthy to be the salt of the earth and the light of the world.
Yes.
But we're only worthy because of what Jesus Christ did at the cross.
Amen.
Amen. We're not Christian because of our goodness, our intellect, our abilities. We are Christian because of the precious, powerful, cleansing, sanctifying, delivering, forever flowing, magnificent blood of Jesus. That's it. For the next few minutes, with the help of God, the Holy Spirit, let us look at the standard of righteousness that God demands of us. Did you hear me? He demands it of us. Jesus' standard was not as the religious hypocrites of his day. And neither should ours be. Today in the church, there's too much sugar and inappropriate lighting in the church today.
Mm-hmm.
And how many know if you have too much sugar, it'll kill you?
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
And if you can't see, how do you know you're going to eventually fall into a spiritual ditch? Amen.
Amen.
Oh, come on.
Amen. It is ever, and matter of fact, you find yourself being malnourished spiritually and spiritually unenlightened. But somebody said the devil's a liar this morning.
The devil's a liar.
Let this world boast in its spiritual perversion, its greed and lust for power, man's inhumanity to man, no reverence or belief in God. However, we who are the remnant, accounted as sheep for the slaughter, we will be the salt and the light of the world, regardless, amen, of what comes against us.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's talk about salt first. The salt of Jesus' day was not refined like today's salt. It can lose its saltiness more easily. Jesus said, what? And if that salt has lost its savior, what good is it for? It's to be what? Cast out and trod under the foot of men. It's no good. Mm-hmm. If salt ain't pure, other things can also come in, ruin it. Come on. There are two principles that has the ire of Satan. Do you know what it is? It is the word of God and it's you. Those two things that Satan would love to taint, the word of God, which is false doctrine, and you as well. That's why we must search our hearts. That's why we must watch ourselves. That's why we must examine ourselves. Because once we tell someone that we are Christian, how do they know they're watching us?
Yes.
And they know how you're supposed to talk. They know how you're supposed to walk. Come on, somebody. They know how you're supposed to be.
Yes.
If you don't believe that, blow it and they'll let you know. I thought you were a Christian.
Amen.
Then all of a sudden we get angry. I am a Christian. And then we feel all convicted, don't we?
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Just tell them this. I ain't what I ought to be, but I ain't what I used to be.
Amen.
I don't care what you think about me. I am the salt of earth and the light of the world. They're going to go like, what? Amen.
Amen.
That's right. Because you are.
Yes.
On that job, you're the salt and the light of the world. Even though they don't even know it.
Amen.
But they don't even know that they're blessed because you were there. They don't even know that. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Number one, Satan is doing everything in his power to dumb down us as being salt and light. He's dumbing down the school with the teaching of godless evolution and so-called sex education and no discipline.
Amen.
There's no discipline in the schools today.
Come on.
Number two, Satan is dumbing down our homes with a lack of physical and verbal discipline.
Come on.
Constant social media, PlayStation,
etc.
with little personal Bible study.
Yes.
Number three, Satan is dumbing down the church with New Age Bibles, not even worth printing.
Yes.
Entertainment and feel good messages, false doctrine, lying sights, and wonders. It's not a pleasant thing. But if you're a Christian, how do you know God has called us to contend for the faith that was once delivered to the saints? And if you do that, how many know it will make the devil mad?
Amen.
Yes.
It'll make your religious non-tata mad.
Amen.
Your co-workers will get angry.
Yes.
And also the sinos. Sinos, what's that? Christians in name only.
Amen.
We got plenty of those. Amen.
Amen.
Sitting in churches today. The only Christian in name. I'm a Christian. How many know if you are, how many know you're going to show what you are if you really are that? Amen.
Amen.
Salt. How many know that? Sometimes, as salt, we come into contact with people that we touch those people in those areas, and it bothers them sometimes. It irritates them sometimes. Because God takes us and marinates us in our family. When we tell them, guess what? That's not the way to live. They get upset.
Yes, it is.
Salt goes into men. Salt is pounding in. It's marinating. And that's what the true, uncompromised word of God preached under the anointing of the Holy Spirit does. It makes people angry. It does. The word of God, I know it pierces even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit and of the joints and marrows. And thank God it does that.
Yes.
And it discerns of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Jesus said in Matthew 10, 34 and 35, and I like it. I love it. He said, I didn't come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace but a sword. He said, I came to pierce you.
Amen.
I came to cut away that which is not of me.
Amen.
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 I came to do that. Well, I come to set man of barriers or odds against his father and the daughter against her mother and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. Woo, glory to God.
Amen.
That means if you're saved, that you saw the light of the world, and your mother-in-law is not saved, how do you know it's going to be some irritation there?
Come on.
Huh? They're not going to like you.
Mm.
They were supposed to.
Come on.
They were supposed to like you. You're a child of God. You're light.
Amen.
I know some of you have never seen a roach in the house because you were born with a silver spoon in your mouth. But if you ever seen a roach, you turn the lights on, they scatter. That's how we are. We the light, we come into darkness, and people don't want to be around us. Nobody want to hear about Jesus. Call somebody. Jesus. Tell them that they have to deny themselves. They don't want to hear that. They want to be tickled today. Amen.
Amen.
They don't want to die. How many of them, when we come to Christ, we're supposed to die?
Come on.
And allow him to put his salt on us. How many of salt make it taste good?
Yeah.
Huh? Yeah. Does it? How many of some of us need some salt?
Amen.
Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Stop being so bland. Some salt. Somebody told me that, I'm not going to call the name, but they invited a couple to come today to church, I guess to bring someone that they know. And they told this couple, they might be uncomfortable here.
Uh-huh.
Praise the Lord.
Right.
Praise the Lord. We want you to be uncomfortable.
Yes.
When you get uncomfortable, that means that's the Spirit of God in the house.
Right.
I don't want to be in a church where I'm not where I'm comfortable.
Yes.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
I want God to read my mail. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Yes.
I want him to read my mail. Don't get mad at me. Get mad at God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm just a pastor. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Woo, glory to God. Lord, salt me up. Salt me down, Lord. Amen. So I can be a preservative in this lost world. And let your light so shine before me that before men that you might be glorified. And then Jesus said, "And a man's foe shall be there of his own household." That's not only talking about the house, but also in the church. There are going to be people in the church world who don't care about you. Amen. Because of what you stand for. I love my other pastors in this valley. But if they don't care about the message of the cross, I don't care if they don't like me because of that. I don't care if they don't like me because I preach the blood of Jesus. I don't care if they don't like me because I preach the baptism of the Holy Spirit. I don't care if they don't like me because I say it's not about self-esteem, but it's about esteeming God. I don't care.
Amen.
I don't need no schism and fad to try to draw people. Just preach the word.
Amen.
That's all we have to do. They come, and they don't, they don't.
Yeah.
Amen. I decided that 11 years ago. You know the story. If I just have to preach to my wife, that's the way it'll be.
Amen.
Yeah. Praise God. Oh, glory.
Amen.
No, I only had 8. Continue to be salt because you might be the only one standing between your family.
Come on.
And hell.
Amen.
Yeah. Your friends and hell.
Mm-hmm.
Your neighbors in hell. Glory to God.
Amen.
How many know when people get in trouble in your family, they might not like coming to church. They might not like what you're about, but time they get in trouble, they call them home.
Amen.
Will you pray for me?
Yes.
Oh. Am I right or wrong? And I hope you guys don't get self-righteous. We all pray for you for what? Well, God didn't tell you that when you was messing up. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Sometimes we get so self-righteous, we forget what condition we were in. A lot of times we turn people off with our self-righteousness. How many know sometimes when you go around people, you ain't got to be quoting 4 or 5 Bible verses. Just walk it out. Just be the light. Glory to God. They'll notice you eventually.
Amen.
When I was working in the prison, I didn't go through the gate every time and quote scripture. I just walked it out.
Amen.
My wife can tell you that a guy walked up to her in the bank. You've heard the story. And he said, "Your husband's name is Ron?" She said, "Yes." He said, "I have never heard him use profanity in the years I've worked around him."
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Spanish inmate one time came to me. He said, "Guess what?" I went, "What?" He said, "I've accepted Christ." I said, "Okay." He said, "No, you don't understand what I'm saying. You took me out of that trepidation van. You always had on Christian radio. And now I'm born again."
Hallelujah.
Come on. Be light.
Amen.
That's what the world needs. Light and salt. Who is it? You are. Tired of Christians walking around feeling so down on themselves.
Come on.
Beating themselves up. Always have a pick-me-up message. You got one today. You're the salt of earth and the light of the world.
Amen. Amen.
That's more important than name it and claim it.
Amen.
You know, salted earth and a light of the world. Amen. Glory to God. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, praise the Lord. You know what? God has not yet poured his wrath out upon this world. And do you know that a lot of people outside those doors know nothing of the wrath of God that is coming? They don't even know the Bible. They never heard of the Great Tribulation period. They've never heard of the mark of the beast. They've never heard of the Antichrist. And sometimes even we in the church act like it's a fairy tale. But how do you know it's still coming?
Yes.
It's just ahead of us. It's right on the horizon. So we got to work while it's still day because night is coming. God is going to judge this world. I know it's not a baby. When we went to the Disneyland Hotel, and they had that great convention there on church growth. Fooey. I didn't hear one speaker says, God is going to judge this world. No, they're not going to say that. They're going to tickle your ear. Amen. Noah preached for 120 years, didn't he?
Yes.
It's going to rain. And they laughed at it. Mm-hmm. And they're laughing at preachers like me today. Brother McGill already told me, he said, Pastor, you're an old-fashioned preacher.
That's right.
That's how they look at you. Remember Brother McGill? That's okay. That's all right. God is old. He said, I change not.
Come on.
Right. He's still the same. Glory to God. I said, he's still the same.
Amen.
I don't care what Washington D. said. Homosexuality is still wrong. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
The world might change, but God doesn't change. Abortion is still wrong.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Praise God.
You call me old fashioned. That's all right.
Yes.
Woo, glory to God.
Yes.
I say glory to God.
Amen.
Wheel of salt and earth. Turn to the 2 Thessalonians in your Bible, please. Starting at the 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 6. I want to show you how important you are to this lost world, if we can. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 6. I want to show you how important you are to this world. Are you there?
Yes.
And know you not. And now you know what withholds, that he might be revealed in his time. What's holding the Antichrist from being revealed right now?
The cross of Christ.
You are. You are the church. Yes. That's why God hasn't revealed it yet. Look at it. And now you know what withholds, that he might reveal in his time. Yeah, the church. You are the salt, the earth. I mean, the salt and the light. Amen?
Amen.
For the mystery of iniquity does already work. Only he who, the church, who now lets. We're hitting the evil now because we're here. We're let until he be taken out of the way. And then after the rapture, what the Bible says, then shall that wicked one be revealed. Does it say that?
Yes.
When we are gone, then shall that wicked one be revealed.
Yeah.
And we will no longer be here to restrain evil. Listen to me, church. You are the salt of earth and the light of the world. And you are the only one that is restraining evil in this world. But once we're taken out, it's going to be hell on earth. Amen. So I'm telling you how valuable you are this morning. Do you believe it?
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
However, one most important point, we still live in an evil world. And we have to keep our faith totally in the work of the cross, which will allow the Holy Spirit to keep us, to help us to show spiritual fortitude, to keep our spiritual saltiness and our youthfulness, to be the disciples truly of Christ, and and also to be spiritually strong and useful. That's what we should be, useful to Christ. And if we fail God in any capacity, the world and even the church will tread our testimony. Did you know that? If we fail God in any capacity, not only will the world tread your testimony, so will the church. The church is very professional in killing its own.
Yes.
Did you hear me?
Amen.
Someone said ISIS takes off next, the church will rip your heart out.
Amen.
We will. Mm-hmm. But how do you know we're not supposed to do that?
Yes.
We're supposed to still not condone our brothers and sisters' sin, but we're supposed to love them.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Love them back into the kingdom, not agree with their sin.
Amen.
However, I do know this. If I repent of my sin, if I fail God, God is going to forgive me. And you as well. And he'll return your status from good for nothing to useless. Oh, come on, somebody. Come on. There's so many people now that are outside those doors who have been hurt in church somewhere, and they don't want nothing to do with God. Tell them that you know a pastor that know a God that will forgive them for any sin that they've ever done. Come on, somebody. And he will take that. I don't care what the church or how the church looks at them as useless. We know a God that can use them. Come on, somebody. Amen. We know God will take their feet out of the marriage clay and set them on a rock to stay. We know that type of God. Amen. How many people have you met or witnessed to, and they tell you that I just can't. What do you mean I can't? I've just been too bad. Come on. Have you met people like that before?
Yes.
Let them know he can wash away any sin.
Amen.
I don't care what you've done. He can wash away any sin. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Do you know what blasphemy of the Holy Spirit is? It's not talking about the Holy Spirit per se. It's about, guess what? Rejecting Jesus Christ as Lord.
Amen.
When you turn your back completely on Christ and trust in something else, that's blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit is the only one that can save you.
Amen.
He's the only one that draws you. Amen?
Amen.
So how many know we don't want God to give people over to a reprobate mind? We still want to pray for those people and say, Lord, have mercy on them as you did on us.
Yes.
Yes.
Why? Do you want to see them destroyed?
No.
The Bible says God takes no pleasure in the death of the wicked.
Yes.
And neither should we.
Amen.
The Lord Jesus didn't die a horrible death that we can live on this earth and not be useless to one hurting world. He died so that we could be a preservative, that we could be salt. That's what he's called us to be, salt. Now let's look at light. Jesus said, you are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill that cannot be hid. I'm so tired of hiding Christians. You hear me?
Yes, I can.
You even know that they're Christian. You need to tell me. I mean, you've been working beside that person for 5 years, and not one time have you ever heard them say Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
But they are Christian. Amen.
Amen.
Man, let me tell you something. When you are born again, and you have the Spirit of God living within you, you can't hold it down.
Yes, amen.
I said, you can't hold it down. I had a friend by the name of Ronnie Roberts, white guy. I'll never forget him. Ronnie used to be he started so much cocaine, they had to remove a bone out of his nose. We attended the synagogue in Colton. And one day, Ronnie still had a problem with those cigarettes, them cancer sticks. But guess what? God gave me enough grace to leave Ronnie alone.
Amen.
Just to pray for Ronnie.
Yeah.
And one day, Ronnie told me this is how he got saved. He said, I used to go home and turn on Jimmy Swaggart and get me a six pack and laugh at him. 1 week, I'm laughing at him. Every Sunday evening, I'm laughing at him. Somebody say the third Sunday. Come on, somebody. He was down on his knees saying, Lord Jesus, forgive me for my sins. Come into my heart. But Ronnie had a smoking problem, but he still loved God.
Amen.
And I didn't say one thing, just kept praying for him. And then one day he said, Ron, guess what? He said, God has taken cigarettes from me.
Amen.
Well, I brought him by his name because Ronnie was bold, man. He was bold, man. He would talk to a telegram pole about the Lord. You hear me? If it was sit there long enough to listen, amen. How many know we're supposed to be the same way?
Yes.
We're supposed to be so excited about Jesus.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. And if you don't have that excitement anymore, that salt is seeping out of you, and that light, ask God to put it back in you today.
Amen.
Yeah. I don't care. Some people have been serving God a long time, an elderly in Christ. I don't know. You're supposed to be on fire more than the young ones.
Amen.
Because you can look back and see what God brought you from.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, come on. Amen. Let me tell you what God has done for me. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Man. Salt is pounded in. Did we say that? Marinated, if you will. Light reaches out. Light is outward and obvious, shines forth and illuminates. Let me say one thing right now. The light that you are is not because of you.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
I'm so sick of Christians always So many preachers preaching, it's all about you. No, can I use a bad grammar? It ain't about you.
Amen.
Whatever light you have, whatever you're doing for God, it ain't because of you, it's because of Him.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
You're just a reflector of the light.
Amen.
Come on.
Don't get it twisted. Mm. We're so quick to put men on pedestals in Christianity. Come on. And then when they fall in their face, we get upset. Well, you the one, you should have worshipped them. They're just a man.
Okay.
That's why you read your Bible. I don't take what comes out of a man's mouth. I read the Word of God to see that it lines up with it. I don't care how long he's been preaching.
Amen.
Because some things are just opinion.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Yep. How many know God used messed up people to preach the Word?
Amen.
Oh, he's a mighty man of God. Yeah, follow him home. That's why this church, man, we point to Jesus.
Right.
Yeah.
Come on.
We lay hands on somebody, they hit the floor, we keep right on moving. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
We don't go out and put out a sign. Hey, look what happened. Somebody got slain in the spirit. It's supposed to be slain in the spirit. Somebody got healed. It's supposed to be healed. It ain't the pastor. It's God. Come on, somebody. Somebody's supposed to be baptized in the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Sometimes I wonder as a pastor, well, why do you do the things you do here? Because I ain't perfect at all. You hear me? Glory to God. How somebody say it's because of God's grace?
Because of God's grace.
We don't encourage that. But if it happens, it happens. But we do want you, when you get off the floor, to at least be chained inside.
Amen.
I've seen people get slain in the spirit, get right up and live. And it was the biggest ahead of they was before they got slain in the spirit. Come on, somebody. Can I tell the truth or not?
Amen.
You're chained by the power of God, the blood of Jesus inside of you.
Yes.
Not because of a miracle. We worship miracles. No, you worship God.
Amen.
Oh, man. Oh, boy.
Amen.
Amen. You know, sad to say, many Christians illuminate little light. We become as hermits, shutting ourselves away in little Christian communities, our little Christian schools and our churches. And we sit around speaking about how evil the schools and colleges are and society, come on, but yet we're not in them restraining the evil that is in them.
Amen.
What are you saying, Pastor? God ain't called us to isolate us, He called us to separate us.
Amen.
Are we good at talking about, and look at the public school and how horrible they are? What have you prayed about it lately? And then you got people buying beans and stuff. And fatigues and hiding out in the mountains. For what? You can't reach nobody there. You can't be light and salt out in the mountains.
Come on. Come on.
Amen?
Amen.
And some of you buying those beans on TV. Oh, it's getting quieter now. God is hitting home. He's hitting home. Amen. There's nothing wrong with being prepared or having a generator, but that's not what it's all about. God didn't call you to hide out.
Amen.
He called you to go forth. Come on, somebody. Oh, come on. Remember, we preached last Sunday when the Holy Spirit fell on Pentecost. They were inside, praising God, worshiping God. Come on, somebody. Goosebumps, prophesying to one another. That's my commentary.
Wow. Yeah.
But not going out as salt and light. And guess what happened? God said what? Persecution. And then all of a sudden the church spread.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. God needs us to go out.
Yes.
Amen. Be the salt and earth and the light of the world.
Amen.
Oh boy. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I shared with some of you a story of a lady that her husband works at the prison. And she didn't want her son to be a police explorer. Because police officers use profanity. Can I say one thing? Correctional officers, prison guards, and free staff use profanity.
Yes,
but I didn't see her telling her husband not to go to work. Come on, somebody.
Come on.
Preach it. So guess what happened? Her son was homeschooled. Well, whatever you want to do. Man, he got wild as could be. Mm-hmm. Got married, had two kids, and left his wife for another woman. Mm-hmm. Sheltered him, you hear me? Mm-hmm. Sheltered him that he might not be the salt of the earth and the light of the world. Mm-hmm. You guys know my son, Ron Jr., I don't put him on no pedestal at all. But he was not homeschooled. He was sent to public school. But he had a dad that believed in this book.
Amen.
Believed in discipline. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I don't know him having any kids out of wedlock that I know of. He won't use profanity around his stepmom and myself. You hear what I'm saying? Yeah. And when he brings his tall linky ring to Blythe, and he's in my house on Sunday morning, 6'7", 28 years old, CHP, Highway Patrol. He will come through those doors.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? I don't, what he's doing out there now, and guess what? Every time he does something, I find out about it. And I don't even tell him. Amen? Why? Because it's the Spirit of God that's doing it.
Amen.
The Bible says to train up a child, not shelter a child. Did you hear me? Train up a child, and then where he go. And when he get older, he should knock the park.
Amen.
I know another young lady used to come to this church. Her kids were homeschooled. Matter of fact, her daughter told the kids out back that I'm smarter than everybody. That family came completely apart. The husband left her. Amen. And the kids are wild. You hear what I'm saying? You know why people don't want to send their kids to public school? Because they're lazy parents. So they put them in a private school, they shelter them away from the world, and then once life hit them, they are just as wild. You understand what I'm saying? No, it's your job to discipline them at your home, so when they go outside those doors, they're going to act in the public school. Righteous, I call her. She had called me on another weapon. She said, "You a pastor? You should have a gun. I got five of them. Think about buying another one."
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
But I remember her mother telling her one time we were eating together. She said, "You know what? You weren't perfect all your life." And it got real quiet at the table. You remember that thing? Don't worry, I'm about to call whose name it is. But how many self-righteous, it stinks in the nostrils of God.
Yes,
I work with this young lady's husband too. There's a church in this town. If you're not a homeschooler, they look down on you.
Mm.
Did you hear that?
Come on.
Matter of fact, I had a partner I used to work with. He said, "You know what? My daughter was homeschooled, but now I want to send her to high school. But now the homeschoolers and the parents are looking at my daughter like she has some disease." I said, "Man, you know what? Send your child to that public school, man. Don't shelter her." And guess what? She's turned out to be an awesome young lady.
Amen. Amen.
She got married. Come on, somebody. Married a nice young man. Come on. But the homeschool person, guess what? Got out in life and acted a complete fool.
Mom.
Did you hear? Now this young lady, I used to work with her husband. We used to work side by side. And not one time did I see him share Christ with either inmate or staff. Not one time did I see him read anything about Christ, though he read the newspaper and played crosswords. Not one time did I hear him invite someone to his very popular church. Not one time. But guess what? God has called us to be salt and light to a lost and dying world. To pray for those young people that are in those public schools. Amen? Because how many know God died for them as well? I'm not saying not to send your kid to no public school, a private school, but what I'm saying, if you do not think because you send them to a private school that they're going to be sheltered from the evil schemes of the evil one.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That's right. Come on.
Turn to Matthew 5:15. Gotta skip those, but it's okay. What does it say? Amen. So how many know we're not supposed to hide what God has within us? You know what? I thank God that there are young men and young women in this church that go to public schools. And they're lighting those public schools because they're being raised by Christian parents. Come on, somebody. Christian parents who send their children in the midst of unbelieving young people. And we have believers who work among unbelievers on the job every day. And some of you talk to me sometimes, Pastor, you know, man, I'm just God. I work with man. I don't know why he treats me the way he treats me. Why do you think he treats you the way he treats me? Because God is trying to work at something in you. Amen. Oh, it's getting quieter than that. Let's go preach outside. I said God allows people to come against you because he's trying to get at something in you.
Amen.
Well, like we're supposed to skip through life unscathed. If you're a child of God, you're going to be challenged. Glory to God.
Amen.
And it's not how people treat you, it's how you treat people.
Amen.
Man.
Amen.
So don't stop crying and stop complaining about it. Because God has placed you in that place as light and salt.
Amen.
I don't care what hellhole you are in, what job you're working on, God has placed you there. I don't see you. If you so burnt out about it, go ahead and quit. Go home and tell your love when I got so upset, I just quit.
Oh.
Bet you'd be sleeping in the garage that night. You hear what I'm saying? Oh, I want a Christian job. Ain't no Christian job. Not even pastor. All I did was a people man. Good gracious. I don't know where they came from. Amen.
Man.
Come on. Man, we had to put people out of the church. Literally pick them up and take them out. So this ain't safe up in here. Amen.
Amen.
People have come and laid guns on the altar. Come on, somebody. You hear me? But how do you know when something happens to you, God is trying to get at you?
Mm-hmm.
I told you before about this guy at the job. I know he didn't like me. He couldn't stand me. And I'm back in the Salvation Station. I'm praying about him. And God let me finish. He said, it's not him I'm trying to reach. I'm trying to reach you.
Amen.
Glory. It was me.
Yeah.
It was me. I'm the one that had a problem. Amen. Amen. Yeah, he was what he was. But God was trying to get something out of me.
Yeah.
When you say, Lord, shine through me. Use me.
Woo.
Let your love flow through me.
Come on.
Look out.
Come on.
God gonna turn up the heat a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
He gonna send some of those irritable people into your past.
Oh.
Remember, you was praying that in church on Sunday. Oh God, use me, use me, use me. Tears flowing down, goosebumps all over you, speaking in tongues. And then by Wednesday, all of a sudden that boss began to bother with you, and all of a sudden you have, well, God. No, I didn't mean that way. What way did you mean? He said, my ways are not your ways, and neither are my thoughts. Come on, somebody. Come on. That's when we're supposed to rejoice. Amen. Like, God will give me another chance. Amen. With that young man, I'm still looking for him. The one that I didn't speak to about 2 weeks ago, the skinhead. God will give me another chance.
Come on.
I'm going to say, God bless you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. All I know, that's all he might need.
Amen.
How you know there are a lot of people that are hurting in this world?
Yes,
yeah.
They
and they're just putting on this front like they all laugh, but deep down inside, they're tore up.
Amen.
You talk to them, all of a sudden, tears begin to flow down their cheeks. But see, a lot of times, we're so concerned about us being hurt, we being hurt, or somebody walking on us, we just bypass people. When we're supposed to be the salt of the earth and the light of the world.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
You know, like, when you ask to be the salt and light of the world, that everything just would be so easy. No, it's not.
Yes, it's hard.
But by the power of God, you can do it.
Because
it's not you. God can make you love the unlovable.
Yes.
I know what I'm talking about because I've been there.
Yes.
Where God just puts supernatural love in my heart for a person. You can do the same.
Amen.
Amen. Let me land the plane.
Thank you.
I know you guys came to hear about how to be a better you, how to maximize your life.
Yes.
How to buy another house or another car.
Wow. Amen.
God ain't thinking about no house and car. No, he's thinking about you.
Yes.
Because when the trump sounds, your house and your car will be there right here. Come on, somebody. God's going to change you.
Amen.
And do you know when you're the salt and light in your neighborhood that they'll know that?
Yes.
They'll know you're Christian.
Yes.
They'll see you when you get up on Sunday morning and good morning and go to church.
Amen.
Amen. Matter of fact, that young lady next door, we were asking her to come to church. There's a boyfriend going now. I remember playing the piano one time. Come on, somebody.
All right.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 I think they had a falling out. He didn't believe in Christmas.
Mm.
So she bought a big old Christmas tree. He was your witness.
I saw
the tree laying out by the road about 3 weeks after Christmas. I put it in the church trash can. Now he's gone. He said, I don't believe in that, but maybe she does. Come on, somebody. Now maybe she's going to go over and talk to her about Jesus.
Yeah.
I know he can tell her she don't need that alcohol that she be drinking. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
If she drink up this water, she'll never thirst again. Are you going to drink it? Come on! Somebody say, I'm the salt.
I'm the
light.
Light.
In this
praise
world,
God.
And, God put me here for that. And they will miss us when we go.
Yes.
Glory to God. I said they will miss us when we go.
Yes.
The number one thing, if you don't get anything out of this message today, all you whiners, woo, about what you're going through on your job or who you're going through with your neighbor and all that, or your family, can I tell you one thing?
Yes.
It's not about you.
Amen.
It's not about you. It's about him. We just been picked out to be picked on. Come on, somebody. If I'm allowing my light to shine as a correction officer when I was at the prison, the Lord gave me so many opportunities to lead people to Christ.
Come
on. Man, I miss working at that prison. Right in that negative environment, God used me. And God will use you right where you are.
Yes.
I'll never forget Mr. Parker. Never forget him. God, if I repeat myself, I'm sorry, I'm getting older. And old people repeat themselves. Matter of fact, if you read the Bible, you see it repeats itself.
Amen.
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 Get off that first page. Come on, somebody. I said, get off that first page. You'll find out it repeats itself. Come on.
Amen.
Get forgiveness of Father. Life of white brother. And chains.
Mm-hmm.
Every time you open his mouth, he talked about Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I love that man. Never forget the time he's standing in that hallway in the screen and that little baby in a carriage and with a social worker. And Mr. Parker in that baritone voice, he said, Matt, are you going to pray for that baby or not? Because if you don't, I will.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Mr. Parker. Come on, man, I can't even close my eyes. I got a gun on, man. What's going on? He said, Mac, if you don't, I will. I said, go stay right where you at, Parker. Man, can I pray for the baby? With one eye open, one eye closed, watching Parker. Come on, somebody. Come on. I said, man, was a lifer, okay? I prayed for that baby. And guess what the baby did? Raised her hand.
Praise God.
Shame is spoke. And the lady started crying. I said, why are you crying? She goes, that baby has never moved before in his life. Glory to God. Thunder. Light of the world. Come on, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb.
Yes. Amen.
And by being salt and light, you don't know what that did to that lady, that social worker. Amen. But we know what it did to that little baby, and she raised her hand.
Amen.
You don't think I've been so tired, Mama?
Yeah.
Man, I had a captive audience. They couldn't go nowhere. You guys are going to try to preach my heart out now. They can go until I brought them back. Come on, somebody. Come on. You know what I mean?
Blessings.
Someone said there's two things that Mac love to talk about. Food and soul. The word of God. Why not? Both of them, when you take them in, they give you life. Don't they? Why not talk about God? Why not talk about what he's done for all of us? Amen. Praise the Lord. And I thank the Lord for you too, Sarge, because I know you're out there in prison, man, telling people about Jesus. Let's read one more Bible at. One more scripture, we're going to land the plane. And I hope I didn't, am I bad as I was last week? When my wife told me I ran her crazy with my nose. And I'm okay. You know? Every Sunday I have to go home and be taken apart. People laying on the floor, baptized in the Holy Ghost, and she worried about my nose. Come on, somebody. Well, how many know that's what a wife's supposed to do?
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
Your pants is too high. Your business problem. But I love her. Amen.
Amen.
She's just looking out for me. Amen.
Amen.
I said, good reason. Man, this morning she was if you didn't, you want a tea now. I had to speak in tongues, so I wouldn't say nothing wrong. Come on, somebody. I mean, even though I'm a shot not told to see you in my kingdom. God had to give me some power. I told him, my mom in heaven. Amen. But give you some cough drops. Well, at least you care about me, honey.
That's right.
So perhaps when I get old, she's going to be right beside me, pushing me.
Right.
Right off a crib. Glory to God. Let me know we can have funny God.
Amen.
I'm almost done. Matthew 5:16. Yes, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Why y'all laughing? What did you say to yourself? Tell the truth and shame the devil.
Yeah, that's right.
Excuse me. 5:16, where we at? Let your light so shine for men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. I wrote here, so do your job. Do your job. That's what it's saying. Mm-hmm. You and I have a responsibility to let our lights shine before men.
Uh-huh.
Not just shine in here. Yes, we are the lights of the world, right? Yeah. And it's okay if you come in and your light is shining. But there is no darkness in here. The darkness is outside. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
We can just shine the lights on each other. Come on. The darkness is outside. Come on. Come here, that light, brother. I want a light. Let me have a light. Let me have a flashlight. Who got a light?
I got
a
light.
That's all we do is shine lights on each other. Okay? Hey, the darkness is outside. Come on, somebody. They need the light. They need the light. They need the light. They need the light outside.
Amen.
Amen. Shining just in here with all the other lights is good.
Yes.
But dark is outside. And the Bible says faith without works is dead. Meaning what? Proof.
Yes.
We need to see your light.
Yes.
And how many know we all have a responsibility to check each other out?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. That's right. Hey. We do. Mm-hmm. You're supposed to check me out. I'm supposed to check you out.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You hear me?
Yeah.
Amen.
We're supposed to watch each other's lifestyle. Mm-hmm. And then hold each other accountable. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You see your brother still, hey, brother, no, don't do that. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Don't do that. All right, man, you're going to lose your testimony. Don't, you know they're going to do that. Put the brick down, man. Don't do that.
Amen.
Just pray for him. Amen.
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 Amen. When we had to throw that guy out the church that day, man, how many know my CO almost kicked in?
Right.
Mom. But all of a sudden, the Holy Spirit stopped me right here. Because at the prison, when somebody like, hey, you go after them, you don't go away from them, you go toward them. Amen. Praise the Lord. I say, thank you, Jesus. Because if I did something stupid, I'd have lost my testimony.
Right.
Wouldn't I?
Yes.
Man, Pastor Ron, choke that dude out. Don't kill the man, though. My great uncle, I love him, but he slapped the preacher one time. I love Papa. Mama said, honey, that's why he suffered the way he did.
Yeah.
They went to some what they call it when you go to a
retreat.
What you call it? No, when you
do retreat.
A denomination when they
retreat.
The bishop and all that meet.
Convention.
There you go.
Oh.
And I guess the bishop sent back some certain orders. But the pastor didn't want to do it. And my uncle, who was the elder in the church, said, well, Pastor, the bishop didn't say that. He said, Anna Marie, sit down and shut up.
Uh-oh.
Papa was about that tall. Papa, man, you hear me? Papa carried a girl. Come on, somebody. Papa taught me how to work. Papa was a Republican. 31 houses and tight as a rubber band. Come on, somebody. I'm talking about tight. Worked me all week for $6 and asked me without enough. Come on, somebody. Amen. Tight. And Papa said, Pastor, why don't you step down at that pulpit and tell me to shut up? He said, I'm not going to bother you in the pulpit, but step down and tell me to shut up. Mama said, when the pastor stepped down, Papa laid into him. They got rid of the pastor. Because Papa was a good title. Whoa! Don't attack the pastor, just leave if you don't like what I say.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise.
Let's land the plane. America is full of Christians who believe in God with their mouth, but our lifestyles speak different. As my mom used to say, boy, you think you're fooling me, but you ain't fooling God.
Amen.
Did you hear that?
Amen.
We might can fool each other, but we can't fool God.
Yes.
The life within us should produce good works to be seen by men. Not to bring attention to yourself,
right,
but to bring attention to God.
Amen.
Amen.
How many know we all struggle with giving God the praise?
Amen.
Something in all of us always want to take the credit.
Mm-hmm.
Come on now.
Amen.
We struggle with that.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. They're here because I did this. I did that. When you do that, you already lost your reward.
Right.
It's hard to keep the mouth shut and say, look what God has done.
Amen.
You always got to add your little 2 cents. Always get quiet now. We all struggle with it.
Yes.
Some of us will be standing in the judgment seat of Christ, saved, but with nothing.
Uh-huh.
Give God the praise.
Amen.
Lord, say, Lord, I don't want to miss my blessing. Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
You being started light in your community or on your job makes things a little better for that community or job, as I just said. Salt and light we have been called to be. To hold back what? Evil.
Yes.
And to show a lost and dying world to eternity.
Amen.
That's
Amen.
Why we've been called. You're the salt of the earth and the light of the world. Whether you feel like it or not,
right.
God said it, and it's time to start acting like it.
Amen.
Whenever heads bowed, here I close this morning. If there's anyone under the sound of my voice who has not accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, you cannot be salt and light unless you know Him. And I'm not talking about joining this church. We don't have no church membership here. We're talking about joining the kingdom of God. But if there's anyone under the sound of my voice who's backslid or not where they should be at in God, and you know that God has called you to be the salt of the earth and the light of the world, with every head bowed and every eye closed, I want you to raise your hand and say, Pastor, I have not been the salt and light that I need to be. And I want to be that salt and light. And I know I can't do it within my own strength. But if I allow the Holy Spirit to work in my heart, I know I can be useful for the kingdom of God. Thank you. I see a hand there. I see hands there. Glory to God. Anybody else? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to stand now. And as we always say around here, when Jesus died on the cross, He didn't die in some side room. Come on, somebody. He didn't do it in some side room, but He died before the whole world. He died naked, not like you see him on the cross with a cloth. Because he is, and he called us to be the same way. Not to be hid, but to be solid light to this world. But if you raise your hand this morning, and you want God to flow through you that you might be most salt and light in this world, I want you to step forward to this altar. I'm not going to embarrass you, but we're going to pray with you. And how many know God? The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all other things will be added unto you. If you want to be salt this morning, he'll make you more salty. That light that is within you, Lord, we want it to shine more, glory to God, into a lost and darkened world. Use us, God, on our jobs, God. When people talk about us, when they come against us, let us stop whining and crying and complaining about it. But Lord, let us rejoice, God, that we've been picked up to be picked on for your glory. And we ask it in Jesus' name. Anybody else this morning? You're backslidden. You're not where you should be in God. Glory to God. You're not where you should be in God this morning. I want you to come down to this altar. Glory to God. Somebody, no more complaining. No more whining this morning. Say, Pastor, I'm going to leave whining at the altar today. Come on down. I'm going to leave complaining at the altar today. I'm just going to give it to God. I'm going to trust God. Hallelujah. I'm going to trust God this morning. In Jesus' name. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father.
I come to you.
In the name of Jesus.
The name above all
names.
I thank you, Father,
for sending your only begotten Son to die for my sin. And right now, by simple faith, I put my trust in what he has done. Because of what he did at the cross. Right now, I'm saved. I'm justified. I'm delivered. I'm sanctified. And I'm free. And not only that, I'm the salt of the earth and the light of the world. And God, I'm asking you to make me more salty. Help me to produce more light that you might be glorified. Let me no longer complain. But instead of complaining, let there be prayer. Let there be no more despair. But let there be faith. Because of your blood and the power of the Holy Spirit, I can do all things through you who strengthened me. Take away every habit that grieves your heart. Give me power over anything that will try to dominate me. Thank you, Lord, for your power, for your blood, for your grace. And your faith. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. 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 And amen.
Glory.
Something beautiful.